Okay, as you can see here, in our previous class also we have learned about the basic term and the definitions of ordered pair. As per the topic ordered pair, and as we have done and discussed about the terms and the definitions of ordered pair, today we are going to solve some questions related to ordered pair. So at first, good afternoon to you all, and let's just start the questions, or let's just start to practice the question here. The first question that is given to you on the screen is like this: why are 1-2 and 2-1 not equal order pairs? I think you have remembered about the order pair or equality of order pair. So as we know, if the corresponding elements of the given pair of order pair are same or equal, that means what? If their components are same, you can see here on your screen, if the first component is similar to this first component of the second order pair, in the same way the second one is equal to the second elements of the second order pair, then we can call they are equal order pair. But here you can see in first, and we can observe that here in the first order pair, the first element is 1 and the second one is 2. But in the second order pair, you can see here the first one is 2 and the second one is 1. It means what? They are totally different or not same or not equal. That's why we can say that they are not equal order pair. But there we need to write the reason why these two order pairs are not equal. So for this, we can give the answer here. 1-2 and 2-1 are not equal order pair because their corresponding elements are not same. Okay, here order pair 1-2 and 2-1 are not equal order pairs because their corresponding elements are not same. Is it okay? So I think there is no problem in the identification of equality of order pair and for giving the reason of equality of order pairs. So let's talk about the other question. And the second question that is given to you on the screen is like this: find the value of x and y if. Find the value of x and y if. So remind one thing: if two ordered pairs are given to you in the equal form, there you can see there is given equal form. It means what? This sign shows us the both order pairs are equal. So if they are equal, okay, what are the definition of equal order pair? They are corresponding elements are equal. So the corresponding elements is x to 6 and y to 7. Okay, because of the definition. So here the first element is equal to first element of second, and the first second element of the first is equal to the second element of second. Okay, so according to definition, as we can write x is equal to 6 and y is equal to 7, because first is equal to first and second is equal to second. So in this way, we can solve or we can find the answer of x or y in this way. Here, by definition, you can see on the screen here, by definition, we are not doing by ourselves, okay? We are going through what? We are going through the definition of what? Of equality of order pair, okay? We are not doing by ourselves. We are going through the definition, and the definition is telling us that the first element of the first order pair is equal to the first element of the second order pair. In the same way, the second element of the first order pair is equal to the second element of the second order pair. So that the first element is equal to the first element of second. In the same way, the first second element of the first order pair is equal to the second element of second. Or in this way, here in the question, we need to find the value of x and y. So here you can see x is equal to 6 and y is equal to 7. This is the answer. Okay. So it is not more hard, too hard, so that you can learn it easily, and I hope to. So let's talk about other. Here we have other question, that is in question number B. The first element of the first order pair is x plus y. The comma is separated. Remind one thing. Comma separated the element. So that after x plus y, there is comma. That's why this x plus y is one element. In this way, this x minus y is second element of the first order pair. And in second order pair, there you can see 4 is the first element and 2 is the second element. Okay. And according to the definition, as we know, the first is equal to the first and second is equal to the second element of the order pairs. So let's solve it. Here we have, look at your screen very carefully. Here, by definition, we are not doing by ourselves. We are going through the definition of equality of order pair. That's why we do like this, x plus y equal to 4 and x minus y equal to 2 here. So x plus y is equal to 4 and x minus y is equal to 2. And this is not the actual value of x or either y. We write here equation first, in the same way in second. Okay. If we talk about the previous question, there we easily found the value of x and y. But here, this is in the addition form x plus y, or in the second one, this is in subtraction form x minus y. Okay, it is not giving us the actual value of either x or y. That's why this is in equation form in compulsory mathematics. You have solved x plus 2 is equal to 3. That is expression. Sorry, that is equation. So in the same way, this is also a equation form. That's why we are giving equation first and equation second. Now we are going to add equation first and second. Okay, we are going to add equation first and second. So after adding, we get the equation. After adding, we get like this. Look here. After adding, here x plus y is equal to 4. This is the first equation. And in the same way, x minus y is equal to 2, which is the second equation. And after adding the two equation, you can see here. So we have to add both sides. I think there won't be any confusion. So look here. In the addition, the sign won't be changed. This is the algebraic rule. That's why here there is no any sign in front of x, so there is also a plus sign, so that both x are in the plus sign. That's why 1x plus another x, that is 2x. But if we talk about y, in front of the first y there is plus, and in front of the second y there is minus. So 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. That is canceling. So we canceled y, and is equal to 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Is it okay? In this way, or x is equal to 6 by 2. Look here, 6 by 2. This is in multiplication form. That's why to find the value of x, we divide another side by the coefficient of the x. That's why we divide 6 by 2 here. So 2, 3 is 6. At last, therefore, value of x is equal to 3. Answer. Here, we got the value of x only in this way. This is, new for you. You are thinking how to add the number, how to add the equations, but you can add the equation in general form too. Okay, like this here. This is the variables, okay, and this is the constant term. Okay, so variable is added to variable and constants are added to constants, like this. Okay, x plus y, and we need to add. That's why between them we will write plus sign, plus x minus y. And after equal to, there are 4 in the first and 2 in the second. Look here. So minus plus cancel, and 1x, 1x right here, or 2x is equal to 6. So you can do like this also, and after this you can do the process in this way. So I think you can do in this way easily. Okay, so after finding the value of x, again we need to find the value of y. So let's find the value of y. And look here on your screen. Again, putting the value of x. Now we are going to put the value of x. Look here. As we got the value of x 3, so here we are going to put the value of x in which equation? Equation first. Then we get, after putting the value of x in equation first, we get, so here the first equation is what? Look here, equation first is x plus y is equal to 4. So we replaced 3 at the place of x. Here we replaced 3 at the place of x. So 3 plus y is equal to 4, or y is equal to 4 minus 3. Therefore, y is equal to 1. Hence, x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 1 is the required answer. That means the required value of x and y are 3 and 1 respectively. And I hope you understood the solutions. And I also hope you can do such type of questions by yourself as well. So let's talk about the other one. And you have the third question, that is, find all the possible order pairs from the following sets. In this question, you have given a set, and from that set, you have to find the possible order pair. Like in the set of compulsory math, as you know how to find the subset from the given set. Okay, so in the same way here also, you need to find the possible order pairs from the given sets, but there is some little bit different. So let's do this. And we have the question, A is equal to set A is equal to A, B. Okay, so let's solve it. Here, A is equal to A, B. The ordered pairs can be obtained in this way. Now, we are going to find out the possible ordered pairs. So we need to use some method, some rules. Okay. So in this way, here also, we use or we apply some rules to find the ordered pairs. Okay. And that rule would be like this. You can see on your screen. Components means the elements which are given to you. Okay, so we have given A and B as our elements. So A component and B component. Is there any other elements? No. That's why again to other side also we write the same element A, B. Look here. A, B. In horizontal row, that means in horizontal line, in the same way we write AB in vertical row. So here in the column, you can see here in the different rows and column, you can see here there we have written AB and AB as well. So here, after how will we make the order pair in this way? So here we can look here. When A corresponds A, we have AA. Then after, when A corresponds to B, so we have AB. The same way, again here, B correspond to A, then we have BA. And similarly, when B correspond to B, we have BB. That means here, the order pair which are given to you in the boxes here are the required order pair, which are formed by using only the two element. Here, we haven't used any other element here. We use only two elements which are given to us, A, B. Okay, so to find the order pair, from the given set, we should find out the Cartesian product, this order pair that we formed or found here is also known as a Cartesian product. Okay, so here just think only one thing, that the elements which are given to you, how many elements are given there? Write in this way, making the boxes in the same way. The same element should be written in this way, down way also. Okay. By increasing or decreasing the column and rows. And similarly, form the relation. From their relation, A to A, A to B, similarly B to A and B to A, B to B, like this. So in this way, I hope you will do these all problems which are given to you in your exercise book. So at last, thank you all. Uh